everyone. So today we are visiting one of Mexico's Pueblo Magicos, or magical towns, in which almost every building here is painted yellow.
Yep, if you are thinking about going to Izamal, after this video, you definitely want to pack your luggage and come visit right away.
Yeah, let's go. All right, so the drive from Merida to Izamal is quite easy. It's only about an hour, 5 minute drive. Because we have a car, we rented it for our stay here. We decided to drive, but you're also able to take the bus that leaves every hour from the bus station in Merida. We want to explore this town fully, so we decided to stay for one night in this cool hotel, which has an amazing view of this historic monastery.
Watch until the end of this video as we will give a room tour of this place.
This city has so much to offer. The famous Convento de San Antonio de Padua, which is the main icon of the city, or the Kinich Kak Moo Pyramid, that has been there since the Izamal's pre-Hispanic history, and much more than that.
This is a town in which you cannot put your camera down. Yucatan is famous for its gastronomy, and Izamal offers many traditional flavors.
Izamal is an absolute fantastic town to explore. But do you ask yourself why it's yellow like we do? Stay with us until the end to find out. So the first location is the famous monastery, which is the symbol of the Izamal town. And this place was built in the 1500s, and it's a prime example of the 16th century architecture of this town. And it's absolutely incredible. Now, this place was built on top of pyramids, on top of Mayan ruins, and that's why it's so elevated. And it's really well conditioned and beautiful.
This place actually is where Juan Pablo II visited before, and there's a museum which is like specially mentioned about it and showing the proof that he was here before. So here they have a little souvenir store, and it specializes about Catholic. So like everything is so cute. This little tower is for baptisms, and like they have like the prayer chants and the bit and all these little shiny things. It's like so cute. I want to bring everything home.
Aww.
So cute. So well done. I think it's Funny. Like jewelry box. Some is not really related to Catholic, but it's really cute, and it's a perfect place for you to buy gift, and the price is really affordable, and I love that place.
Yeah, this place is so well preserved and beautiful, and there's just so much history. As you walk around, you see all, you know, centuries old history everywhere around you, and it's really beautiful here.
Yeah, I think I absolutely like can spend a whole day here just explore, walking around and taking photos.
Yeah, absolutely. It's very photogenic. We took a bunch of photos here too. I think it's gonna come out good. So this courtyard that we're sitting at right now is actually the second biggest Christian courtyard after the Vatican, so it has that significance as well. Very peaceful, beautiful, historic place. You know, you just walk around and there's history everywhere, and all the buildings, almost all the buildings are yellow. It feels very safe as well. You just walk around, it's a small town. Feels very safe, people are very friendly, and it's just like you're coming to a hidden gem in Mexico, you know, it's beautiful. So now we are back at our hotel here in Izamal, and here is the room tour that we promised at the beginning of the video. So the room has a very kind of a rustic feel to it. There are several options for hotels, and the reason we booked this particular hotel is the fact that it's so central. It's literally right in the center of the city. And also the beautiful view of the monastery. Let me show you. Yeah, I can't get enough of this view right here. Just from our room, looking at this beautiful monastery from the 1500s. It's incredible. So they only had the two double bed available for us, but this room has one of the best views, as you saw. Besides that, we have the bathroom here, a shower. We got a TV right here. We got Rosie. We got the fridge and AC, which is really important. You need to have AC in Mexico. So happy that I came with it. But I just love this beautiful view of the monastery here. Really nice.
So long since the last time I see this, but like here they still have newspaper that everyone come here and buy the news. Like it's so cool. Like I haven't seen it for like I don't know when the last time I saw it, but amazing. So here in this little area they have a small market where you can come here and buy souvenirs. The price is really affordable.
So since we got to Mexico, Rose has been looking for a hat. Whichever city we go to, she's always looking for that perfect hat. We haven't found it yet, but I think one of these next few times, we're gonna find the hat that she likes.
Approximately 10 hours later.
You found your hat finally.
I finally found my hat after like 10 times of looking for it.
Few different cities, you found it. Cool.
Muchas gracias.
And a surprise too. Very welcome again at the Yellow City, and like and subscribe.
All right, Izamal.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
To say that the architecture here is very unique. Most of the house here is painted in yellow and white. And yeah, look at all the windows and the door. Have a great combination of the color.
Hey, buddy.
For
the sun.
They don't look to the side.
Oh, looks great. All right, guys, so now we have a friend Marco and El Chapo here. We're gonna go around Izamal and learn more about it.
Yeah,
let's go.
It's a very beautiful city.
All right,
let's go take a tour. It's Cochimba. Cochimba in Mayan language.
Cochimba means let's go.
Let's go.
Cochimba. The top down, so we have a convertible. And what's cool about Izamal is that it's such a small town. There's only 40,000 residents, so everybody knows each other. As we're going around, everybody's saying hi to each other, and that's also part of the reason why it's so peaceful and it's so safe here. So now we are at Capilla De Los Remedios, which is a church dating back to the 1700s. So now we are heading up the biggest pyramid here in Izamal, which is called Kinich Kak Moo. And what's incredible is that it's just on the side of the street. So you're literally walking on the street next to all the yellow buildings and you see this big pyramid, and we're gonna go up it. And this pyramid was built in 400 to 600 AD, so it's very old. And what's pretty cool about it is that it's completely free. You just come out here and you enter and you come up and see it.
Bienvenidos amigos, espero que la sigan disfrutando en Yucatán. Malotun, tulaka, puxica, malotun. Mim, I hope you enjoy and has a good life. Like and subscribe.
Ah, muchas gracias. So in the last couple days, as we were walking around the street, we kept asking everyone, what is their favorite restaurant? Where do they recommend for someone who's visiting Izamal? And almost everybody said you need to go to Kinich restaurant. And that's where we are at now for lunch. And looking forward to having some authentic Yucatan food.
Yeah, the restaurant looks really beautiful. The design is very unique and different.
Yep.
And yeah, the staff is friendly as well. So we're looking forward to see how the food is.
Yeah, I'm excited. Alright, so the food's here, it looks very authentic. Rose is getting the pollo pibil, which is this chicken in orange sauce. And here we have some local empanadas, the handmade tortilla with some sauce and beans. What I'm getting is roleno negro.
Tastes very unique, you know, it tastes both familiar at the same time it's different. I think I feel familiar to it because they have tomato and orange sauce, but at the same time there's some spices and seasoning that make it taste different as well.
That is delicious. It actually sounded much better than it looks, but I think it's gonna taste good as well. As you can see here, it's a mix of chicken and pork. It's interesting. It has kind of a burnt taste. It's like a charcoal burnt taste. Now the final question is, why are most of the houses in this city yellow? Now this dates back to 1000 BC because yellow is a very holy color to the Mayans. And back then, many of the houses here were colored yellow as well. But the main reason is the sun and corn, both were written in the Mayan books, and also the Vatican color because this is a Catholic city. And back when John Paul II came here to visit, most of the houses here got repainted yellow again in anticipation of his visit. So that's the reason why this is yellow. All right guys, so that's a wrap up for today's video. We had an amazing time in Izamal. What did you think about it?
Yeah, this is just a dream place. Like, you know, everywhere painted in yellow is very artistic. And yeah, the architecture is very unique as well.
As you walk around, there's so much history. And it's so beautiful. Like, we were constantly taking photos wherever we went, and people are very friendly. It's a small town, so it's very safe, and everybody knows each other, and it's just a really nice pueblo, little town.
Yeah, it's a stunning city, and we really, really recommend you to visit.
Absolutely. I think you come to Merida, to the Yucatan area, this is a must, because it's also one of the Pueblo Magicos, or the magic towns of Mexico, so it's definitely worth to visit.
Yep. So yeah, we had an amazing trip here.
And if you guys enjoyed this video and the tour of Izamal, don't forget to like and subscribe because we have a lot more videos coming your way.
Alright, thank you for your support and thank you for watching until the end of this video.
Cheers!